Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Northdown Center here in Amherst, New York, just outside of Buffalo. I'm Gordon Zeppelin coming to you live up here just across from the finish line. We're about to get things underway. We're going to start off with the Canadian and the U.S. national anthems. And after that, we'll start off with the Heartland men 777-meter heats. We'll have three heats. So this here, folks, good morning. It's a bit of a cold morning here just outside of Buffalo, New York. Most of these skaters getting up before 6 o'clock. You know it's skating season when you get up and the rooster tells you to go back to sleep. Just waiting for the officials to get situated on the track. We'll get the ice crew out, get the blocks laid, and we'll get this first set of heats underway shortly. Again, we're starting off with the Heartland group, which is different from the normal age class, as it is an age class, but only in the fact that you have to be 12 years old by a certain date in the year and have a qualifying time to race. The benefit of the Heartland category allows for a lot of faster skaters to get paired with each other and practice a lot more race tactics, which helps benefit them when it comes to the AM Cups and Short Track Nationals. We saw a lot of great racing last year at Nationals, including my personal favorite highlight, the Yuri Kola, where Yuri and Alexander Breuer went into a corner, came out in what can only be described as Blades of Glory-esque form, and Yuri almost made it across the finish line before falling. Yuri was disqualified in that fantastic finish, and he is here today, so we'll have to see if he has any special finishing poses for us today. I also understand that we have some viewers in Australia this morning. So welcome, g'day, although it's probably, I would assume it's probably closer, well, it's either closer to midnight or after dinner time. We will be streaming today for probably approximately close to 9 hours. We will take a break and cut our stream at lunchtime. We take our long break. We will leave the stream up during the shorter resurface breaks. And don't forget that we have our chat feature paired with our live stream. So if you have any questions, comments, please feel free to ask. We'll try to check back regularly. Still waiting for the first Heartland group to come out of the heat box. Should be getting underway shortly. We do have the blocks out. We have water being laid in the corners. Looks like the whole ice crew is ready to go. We are a little bit behind schedule, but not too much. And as I said, we will be streaming all today's races and all of the races tomorrow. So while we have this time here at the beginning, I'd like to thank our sponsors. Would not be possible without the help of ASAI, the Amateur Skating Association of Illinois, as well as our donors, like the O'Toole family, as well as the contributions of Jim Pizzo. Jim Pizzo actually designed our sick logo. I see a helmet cover coming out of the tunnel, so we should be just about ready to start. So this is the 777. In the first position, we have what are the odds? Yuri Kola. Second position, we have Anton Peterson. And we have Raul Zarorski. Followed by Christopher Langridge. And finally, Evan Flaherty. I've got that right this year, folks. Last year I kept calling him Flaherty, and his parents promptly corrected me on that. And they're off. They get through the corner clean. Evan Flaherty having to stand up after the start. Evan very good on the start. Out in front in first position, it's Yuri Kola, followed by Peterson. Moving up on the inside into second position was Langridge. And Rawl trying to make his way through. Evan Flaherty moving in to fourth position. Had to put his hand on the back of Peterson. Lost some speed, falling behind the pack now. Yuri with a sufficient lead out in front. Langridge trying to chase him down. Yuri has a full straightaway lead on the group. Evan Flaherty now moving up on the inside into third position. That's the bell lap, so one lap to go for Yuri. Evan trying to chase down that second place spot. So Yuri unofficially finishing in first, followed by Langridge, followed by Flaherty. Out of these heats, they're taking the top finisher plus the next two fastest to advance to the A final. Now the second heat coming out on the ice. In this heat we have Gunnar Olsen. In second position we have Adam Horath, as well as Lucas Anderson, three ASC members in the first three spots. Fourth spot, Jonathan So from Dominion, followed by Clayton DeClement. This is another 777. Again, top finisher plus the two fastest times will advance toward the A final. And they're away clean. Anderson moving in the first position, followed by Gunnar Olsen. Gunnar, last year at Nationals, actually fell and cut his leg through his cut-proof suit and had to get stitches, had to pull out of the remainder of the competition. He raced earlier this month in Calgary. He's off to a good start this season. Still Lucas in first position, followed by Gunnar. Sitting in the third spot is Jonathan So. Followed by Horth. Adam moving up on the inside and falls in the corner at the apex. Goes into the pads. Does not appear to be injured. Olsen now in the first position. Followed closely by So. Anderson in the third spot. Again, top finisher moving on towards that A final. Making a move on the inside was So into the first place spot. So unofficially, Jonathan So crossing the line first, followed by Gunnar Olsen and Lucas Anderson. We'll have to see if Gunnar moves ahead based on time. Now we move on to the third and final heat for the Heartland men. In the first spot, we have Michael Koenig from Glen Ellyn, Illinois. Second spot is Timothy Yu. Then Henry Middlebrook. Followed by Richard Anglin. And closing out that group is Tim Van Fleet. Looks like the ice crew didn't really have to take any time at all after that fall in that last race. It's a clean start as Koenig gets out into that front spot, followed by Middlebrook. Michael Koenig represented the U.S. last year in Italy, and this event is one of the qualifiers for the University Games in Kazakhstan this coming winter. Michael Koenig looking to try to make both the short track and long track team. It's still Koenig in front, followed by Yu. Middlebrook sitting in the third position with Anglin in the fourth spot. Michael getting passed on the outside by Yu. Michael going to have to respond here. They're on the bell lap. So it'll be you crossing the line in first, followed by Koenig. We'll have to see if Michael looking back at the referee's box, wondering how many laps they had left. Was unsure. So we'll have to see who advances out of those groups into the semifinals. Next we have the Heartland women's 777-meter heats. We've got four heats for the ladies. In this heat we have Haley Choi out of Potomac. Mia Crone out of Glen Ellen. Sydney Terpenning out of Adirondack. And Ella Trozen out of Midland. And it's a clean start as Haley Choi is out to an early lead, already building a gap between herself and the field. Mia Crone currently in that second place spot, followed by Sydney Terpenning and Ella Trozen. This is Haley's first year competing in the Heartland age group. She was too young last year. She did have a qualifying time. We'll have to see how she does on her first time out. Haley now with a half lap lead over the group. In second position is Sydney Terpenning. Same thing for this group, taking the top finisher along with the fastest time. That's a bell lap for Haley Choi. She's got the pack in her sights. She won't lap them. Haley Choi finishes coming around in second position. It's going to be Sydney Terpenning. Now the second heat for the Heartland ladies, we have Mame Biney, Stephanie Velez, Una Wilhoit, and Grace Trozen. Sorry, scratch that. We only have three starters on the line. Does it get away clean? Trying to figure out which one is scratched from this race, folks. It's a little difficult to see the helmet covers from a distance. I believe it is Mame Biney who is scratched from the event. Not sure if she's here today or not. But out in first position, Stephanie Velez. Following closely behind in second is Grace Trozen. And finally by Una Wilhoit. Again, taking the top finisher from each heat and the next fastest time. Velez building a 5-meter gap over the other two competitors. As they come around to the bell lap, Velez just needs to stay upright here, and she'll cross the line in first position, qualifying to move on to the semifinals, trying to get into that A final. It's Velez finishing in first. Finishing in second was Grace Trozen, and finishing in third was Una Wilhoit. In the third heat, we have Sammy Holmes, Elena Schwartzik, Renee Miller, and Melissa Koenig. Melissa Koenig, the head coach of the Glen Ellyn Speed Skating Club. So, competing here today with her son, Michael. And we have our first false start on the day. And they're off. They get to the corner cleanly. Sammy Holmes out in front. Followed closely by Elena. Sitting in third is Renee Miller. And in fourth, Melissa Koenig. Melissa's sister, Laura Henderson, is probably our biggest fan. Still same 3 leaders, same order out in front. Coming up on 3 laps to go. A pass by Renee Miller moving into that second place spot. Renee trying to chase down Sammy. Renee makes a move on the inside. It's the bell lap. 1 lap to go. Sammy's got to move up a spot if she wants to guarantee her qualifying into the A final. So Renee made the pass with 1 lap to go. She finished in the first spot. Finishing in second was Sammy. Sammy going to have to see if she can advance through on time. And in the fourth and final heat for the Heartland women, we have Katie Toth, Julie Latte, Cece Long, and Rebecca Shumsky. And they're off. Last heat for the Heartland women. Last guaranteed qualifying spot. Although being in the final heat, you could potentially know what time approximately you need to hit. There's Katie Toth out in front. She's got a red line to blue line lead over Shumsky. Shumsky getting passed on the inside by Latte. Latte trying to chase down Toth. As Latte is closing the gap. Field is spread out. Coming up on 2 laps to go. Toth trying to keep Latte at bay. Gap currently locked in at about 5 meters. And bell lap for the 2 leaders. As Cece Long fell with 2 laps to go. Katie Toth finishing in the top spot, followed by Julie Latte. Latte tried to catch up and close down the gap. She made some ground, but then couldn't close anymore. So now we move on to the junior AB men, 777. In this race, we have Leonardo Tau, Leonardo Toe, sorry, Brian Rim, and Raphael Howell. Started taking his time. Looks like we'll have a false start. There was movement on the line. And they're away clean, taking the top two finishers along with the fastest third out of these two heats to move on to the A final. Brian Rim out in front, already building himself a blue line to blue line lead over Howell and Toe. Howell currently sitting in second position, followed by Toll. Should be a battle between these two for that second place spot. As second place would advance into the final. Rim settling into a rhythm. Just needs to stay on his feet, get to the finish line in one piece, and he'll advance to the final. Coming up on one lap to go. Rim still with a full straightaway lead. Taking it easy. Coasting as he coasts around toward the final corner. And he'll take the top spot. And finishing in second position was Howell. So he gets that guaranteed qualifying spot. Toe will just have to wait and see if his time is fast enough to advance through. In this second heat, we have Jacob Stainbrook, Matthew Gravella, and Aiden Lewis. Only two skaters in this race. Out in front is Matthew Cravella. Followed by Stainbrook. Aiden Lewis is a scratch from this race. These two will have a easy skate into the final. They're on the bell lap. It'll be Cravella, followed by Stainbrook.
Thank you.
And skaters for the next heat lining up on the wrong side of the track. I believe this is the junior ladies 777 meter. Moving on the line, so that'll be a false start. And they managed to get away clean. Slow start for this group. We're still waiting on our next set of heat cards. Sorry, folks, I don't have the name roster to call this race. Pass up on the inside and move coming from the outside. And going from third to first on the outside as they're picking up the pace. A pass going through on the inside, coming into that corner. This girl's getting aggressive. Leader now building a gap for the rest of the three, trying to lock it down. I assume it'll be the top finisher, if not the top two, advancing into the semifinal. Trying to get through on the inside, got blocked. Looked like same two skin suit skaters. Closing down on the leader, trying to set up a pass on the inside. They bump. Bell lap, one lap to go. She lost her speed trying to set up that pass attempt. She's going to have to either pass and kicks a block in the far corner, manages to keep her feet. They get across the finish line. Next heat, we have Christine Lee, Caitlin Kaiser, and Ava out of Potomac. And I'm going to try to call these the best I can, folks. Still waiting on the skater rosters. Not my typical scenario. Usually I'm calling hockey games and I only have to deal with 24, 25 guys aside, but we have over 150 skaters here today. Makes keeping track of things a little difficult at times. And next thing you know, your copier jams and you're down your skater roster for a couple of heats. And another false start. Or actually, maybe it was a hold to get water down in the near side corner. This second heat, 7-7-7, underway. A little bit of a quicker start out of this heat compared to the last. The pass comes through on the outside. And we got one skater coming way wide, going all the way from fourth to second. Trying to close down on that top spot. Split into two and two. Fall exiting that corner. Into the pads, manages to get up. Trying to pass on the inside, going to the corner. Was blocked. Coming up on two laps to go. Leader still hanging on. Trying to set up another pass attempt. Exiting the corner, trying to come through on the inside. Stutter step. Manages to pass just coming into the corner. And it's one lap to go for our two leaders. Trying to pass through on the inside. Lost a little bit of momentum in the corner. Trying to make a dash for the line. You ready for our next heat? Coming to the ice is the Junior Seamen for their 777-meter heats. And going to the wrong starting line again, this rink is actually... In my book, I would consider this rink backwards. Normally, you would start on the far, or you would start on the near side in a 500. The 500 starting line is actually on the far side of the rink here, and the finish line is on the near side to the bleachers. So a couple skaters getting a mix-up. They're not used to starting the 777 on this side of the rink. And this Junior Seamen 7-7 heat. Clean start through the corner. Pass from third place into second. Leader trying to put a gap early. There, all four skaters are now evenly spaced. They come through the corner. It's going to be three laps to go. Still no change in the order. Gaps still even, but have widened. And it's one lap to go for the leader. As leader crosses the finish line, standing up, I believe the top two will advance out of this heat. And false start on the second Junior Seamen 777 heat. And another false start. And with that second false start, one skater disqualified exiting the track. So we go down to three skaters for this heat. Skaters going side by side through the corner. It's four-man heat down to three after the disqualification. Three skaters staying relatively close together with three laps to go. Two leaders still relatively close together, coming in at the bell lap. This is his third junior C-men heat underway. Another false start. Not sure if it's the early season jitters. I think the last four races have all false started. And now the four skaters get away clean. Skater falling, exiting the corner. Manages to get up, skates away. Looks like he's okay. Gaps between positions 1 through 3 lapping number 4. Battle right now, trying to catch up to first place. And on the final lap, coming through the corner, trying to set up the pass. Look, he's going to try to go on the inside line and gets blocked off.
Unofficially,
We're going to go to our first resurface break. So we'll be back in approximately 10 to 15 minutes. And welcome back, folks. I'm going to start off this second set of heats with the Senior Master Men 777. So we have Joel Kegel, Philip Sott, Jeremy Senanayaki, and Henry Withers. Looks like they're finally ready to get underway. And a whistle. Another false start. Like I said, folks, it must be the early season jitters. Must not have been practicing their starts too much, focusing on the corners and straightaways. But it is the beginning of the season. The start, if you can't start, you can't finish. And they managed to get away clean this time, as it's Withers out in front. Moving into second position with an inside pass was Sott. And sitting in third position is Kegel. Withers still out in front. Sott closing down the gap, though. And Sott taking an easy pass on the inside into first position. All these skaters will advance to the A final. That's one lap to go. Sott still leading. At the finish, it's Sott, followed by Withers. And here comes Joel Kegel at the finish. Now we move on to the Master Women's 777. In this heat, we have Jen Cola, Natalie Rodrigue Hasselback, Nicole Zayats, and Susan Mishiagna. And they're off as they get into the first corner cleanly. As Natalie's out in front, followed by Nicole. Field spreading out. All skaters from this heat will advance to the A final. Still Natalie out in front. With Nicole in second. Jen Cola sitting in fourth. With Mishiagna in third, trying to pass into second position. Mishiagna gets the inside line, moving into second position. That's one lap to go for the senior ladies. And Natalie was looking around. It wasn't sure if she had finished or she had one more lap to go. Might need to grab a cup of coffee this morning. Wake up so you can hear that bell ring. You don't want to skate too many extra laps, as it's already tiring enough being up this early on a Saturday morning. Next up, we have the Junior D, formerly known as the Midget Men's Division. We've got three heats for the 777. In this race, we have Sean Kim, Oliver Rogalski, Sean Lippa, Peter Andrews, and Jack Housen.